Hi, this is Vijay Kumar, and today's session we'll see how to call a report from form in D2K. So how to call the report from form, and first in this example, first I created one report. Say the report name is rep1. I created one report and this report is rep1, and I created this report to show the employees data. Okay, and in this report I created one input parameter, and the input parameter is DNO. So this is a parameter I created, DNO. So this is for to input the department number. At runtime, if I input the department number some 20, so it will show all the employees list working for 20. If I show the employees department number 30, then it will show all the employees working for 30. So this is input department number. Then so I'll run this report. I'll run the report. So here I input 30. Then so run this. Then it is showing all the employees list working for 30th department. Next. So I run the report again. So this time I input department number 40. Then it will show all the employees working for 40th department. I think no employee working for 40th. So it is empty. So this is one report. Now I want to call this report from form. Let's go to form builder. Let's go to form builder. So I'm creating a form. So then build new form manually. So one form is created. In this form I create a block. So this build a new data block manually. Okay. So block is created. Next, canvas is also created. Block is created and canvas is created. So go to this canvas. Then, so in this create one text item. So the text item is for to input the department number. Next, so take one button. So this is one button. I input the department number in this text item. I click the button. The moment I click the button, I want to call the report. So when I click the button, so the report should be invoked. So just go to the properties of this text item. So change this name to DNO. Okay, change this name to DNO. Next, go to this properties of button. Some button name is something like B1. Next, push button. So what the button name is, label is report. Label is report. Okay, then so here I enter the department number and click the report. When I click the report, I want to call the report. Then see here, so here I input the department number some 30 and click the button. So when I click the button, I want to invoke the report. In that report, I want to show only the employees working for 30th. Not only calling the report, I want to pass this value 30 from form to report. Not only just invoking the report, I want to pass this value from form to report. When you are invoking the report, so pass this 30 to the report. So anyway, in report one parameter is created and pass this value to that parameter, so that report will display only the employees working for 30. Here if I enter suppose 20, then when you click the report button, a report should be displayed, and this value 20 should be passed to that input parameter, and it should display the only employees working for 20. Okay, so this is my requirement. Then so when user click the report button and call the report, for calling the report, so we create one trigger for this button. So that is PLSQL editor when button pressed. When button pressed, so here you write the code. You write the code to display the report. Okay, how to call the report? For calling the report, there is a built-in. What that built-in is run product. Run product is the built-in to call the reports. So which application you want to call? I want to call the reports, and what is the report path? D colon Vijay RP1 dot report1 dot RDF file. So synchronous runs in two modes, synchronous mode and asynchronous mode. And what do you want to call? I want to call the report runtime, not design time. I want to call the runtime. So, and it's a file system. And what is P1 is? What is this P1? See, what I said, when you call the report, I want to pass the value entered in form to the report. Then how to pass values from form to the report? To pass values from form to the report, we need to create parameters. Okay, we need to create what parameter, and we can't pass the parameter one by one parameter to the form to the report. So what we can pass is parameter list. So create a parameter list and add the parameter to the parameter list and pass the parameter list to the report. So create what parameter list and add the parameters to the parameter list and pass this parameter list from form to the report. So how to create the parameter list? So there is a built-in function available, create parameter list. So just give the parameter list name. I am giving the parameter list name as temp. Next. So after this, you add some parameters, like one is how to add the parameters to the parameter list. By using this built-in procedure, add underscore parameter. So to which list you want to add? P1. Then what is the next one is param form. Okay. So parameter form, like parameter form is displayed. So if you want to show the parameter form, say yes. If you don't want to show the parameter form, say no. So suppose assume I want to show the parameter list, I am saying parameter form yes. So if it is set to yes, then that parameter form is displayed. If it is set to no, so parameter form is not displayed. Next, I am adding another parameter P1. So like what the parameter name is DNO, and this is text parameter colon block 2 dot DNO. What is this colon block 2 dot DNO? So what is the block name? You created one block, what that block is block 2. So this block 2 contains one text item. What the text item name is DNO. In the text item you entered some department number. So whatever the department number you entered, so I want to pass that value from the form to the report. So here P1, parameter name is DNO, type is text parameter and block dot DNO. Next. So another parameter P1, destination type, text parameter, destination is what? Screen. So you want destination to be what? Destination to be screen or any file, PDF file, etc. So what is the destination type? So after adding these parameters, next call the report, run product, reports. So file name, and there are two modes, synchronous and asynchronous mode, runtime, next parameter list. Okay, so I'll copy this code to the when button, press trigger, then compile this. So compile this. Now the code is compiled. So after this code is compiled, then close this. Next, run this form. So here enter department number 30, click this button, report button. Okay, and the okay, see that. So I entered department number 30. At runtime, I entered the department number 30, and this 30 is passed to this parameter. Next, run this report, then it will show the list of employees working for 30. See this, all these employees are working for 30. Okay, then, like suppose again, once again, I run this. So here now input department number 20, click this button. So the report is invoked, as well as this 20 is passed to the report. 20 is passed to the parameter form. Next, when you run that report, so it will show all the employees list working for 20th department. Then see this 20. So the value 20 is passed to this parameter, and click this report. So it is showing the list of employees working for 20. But when you run this report, I don't want to show the parameter form, okay. If you don't want to show the parameter form, then there is a what parameter is param form. By default, param form is set to what? S. We have set that value to S. That's why it is showing the parameter form. You set it to no, then it will not show the parameter form. Okay. So, thank you. Thank you for watching this video.